How full are you feeling so far? Hasn't it been incredible? Yeah. I'm like, oh my goodness me. It's just been so precious. The time with family, the time with friends, with Holy Spirit. It's just gorgeous. If you're near someone, why don't you just say it's been gorgeous? Gorgeous time. It has. My name's Chloe. I'm one of the senior leaders in Catch a Fire in London. And it's an honor and privilege to be back in the house here in Toronto in the mothership. And we're excited for this afternoon. We have the incredible Steve Long sharing with us this afternoon. And we'll be talking a bit about that later. But I want to encourage you, just welcome you to come forward and worship. I'm really excited too to have Marcel and Ruth leading worship. They are off the charts, incredible, an amazing team. We love you guys, and even now, yeah, just thank you, God, that you're going higher. There's going to be such an accelerated season over these next few years, and I just felt the Lord's going to be pushing you like you've never been pushed before. It's time to get out of that boat like you've never got out of that boat before, and it's going to be wild. Get ready for the rapids. Oh, come on, Lord. Why don't you just lift your hands to Him right now and expectation. Holy Spirit, dear Holy Spirit, we welcome your presence afresh this afternoon. We honor your presence in this place. The years of honoring the Holy Spirit and the foundations of this church, God, we thank you that we're just bouncing off the foundations that have been laid, but we ask for a fresh touch this afternoon. How hungry are you this afternoon? It's not about waiting to be led in worship. Just even now, engage with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. It's all for Him. And we declare this afternoon that you're worthy, Jesus. You're worthy to be praised. You're worthy to be worshipped, King Jesus. We love you. We love you. We love you. Come on, tell Him He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. We love you, Jesus. We love you, God. We love you. We love you. We love you. You're here for Him. You're here for Him. So love Him. Love Him like He deserves this afternoon. Love Him like He deserves. Will you thicken your presence, Holy Spirit? Will you flow like the river from this place? Ha. Stir our hearts, God, for you. Stir our hearts for you.
celebrate you. We celebrate you today, God, and who you are and all you do.
Thank you. our firm foundation. Forever I will trust, forever I will trust in you. Yes, just declare this. Forever God is faithful, forever God is strong, forever God is with us, forever. His love endures. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. Forever. Oh. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. Have a song to sing right now, and it's our song of declaration, saying that God is worthy. And so God, we choose to declare, we choose to proclaim how worthy and how consistent and how faithful you are. So let's just raise up a song, let's raise up a new song, let's raise up our voice to declare his goodness. Yeah.
Faith arise, let faith arise.
lots of faith to draw from. Come on, one more time. Let's sing, let faith arise.
Let faith arise. Let faith arise. Let faith arise. Let faith arise. Arise, arise, arise. Arise, arise, arise. There's no more death in us. There's life, life, life. Oh, the same Spirit that raised him from the dead lives in us today. Let faith arise. It's time to rise. It's time to rise. Wakey, wakey. It's time to rise. Wakey, wakey. Time to wake up, oh, you sleeper. It's time to rise. Let him shake you today. Let him fill you today. Rise, 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 rise. His glory's here. His glory's here. His morning glory. Oh, his mercy is new today. You are good.
time.
Now you won.
You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let me down.
You are good. is wrapping around you.
We sing. is our King, clothed with love. His glory unveiled, and he shined like the sun. Here is our King, victorious one. Oh, who gave his all, the wages of sin undone. We sing
just lift up your own song. Just let it bubble up, just let it bubble up.
Oh!
He's holy. Just as the guy started to sing that, I heard the Lord say, ha, it's time to fly. It's time to soar. Ho! It's time to hear the lion roar. Ha! Over again. Whoo! And some of us have forgotten that he's gentle king, but he's the lion. Ha! He's the lion. Whoo! Ha! Whoo! Whoo! Ha! It's time to get back on the mane of the lion. Ha! Just like little Lucy, whoo! In the Chronicles of Narnia, grab hold of the lion. Ha! Whoo! Ha! Because he's holy. And he's worthy. You know, the angels declare, he's holy, he's holy, he's holy, he's holy. And we get to jump on the back of the lion, the Holy One. I mean, as if, oh, Holy Spirit, we honor you. Whoo. It's time to fly. It's time to soar. It's time to hear the lion roar. Spread your wings and fly. Come on. Spread your wings and fly. You're no longer clipped in the kingdom. The kingdom of God is the perfect kingdom. So spread your wings and fly. There are no clipped wings in the kingdom of God. We go through times of inner healing. We go through times of abandonment in our hearts where we don't know where we're going, what we're doing. But it's time to fly. Fly again. Oh. Come on, spread your wings. Because he's holy. Ho! And while you fly, you've got to learn to drink and drive. So while you fly, you've got to learn to drink and drive. So come on, start to drink as you fly, as you soar. Drink him in. Because he's asking us today, whom can I send on behalf of us? Whom can I send? Ho! Who can I send on the back of Aslan? Woo! Who can I send that's going to drink and that's going to drive at the same time? Flying higher. Flying higher. So come on. Father, I ask even now from your heart to everyone in this place that you'd release a fresh impartation of being able to fly high, but to drink deep at the same time. You know, sometimes as leaders, we become serious because it's pressures. Whoo. But you know what? I want to be bowing down under the influence of the Holy Spirit, not under the influence of the circumstances of the world. I want to be bowing down in awe of the King, not shoved down under the weight of the circumstances. And as leaders and across this room, we've got to learn to drink and drive again. So just put a hand on the shoulder of the person next to you, because he's a holy God. But you know what? Why don't you encourage them? We've been declaring his holiness. We've been declaring the hallelujah. But it's time to go to new levels of drinking and driving in the spiritual sense with him. Encourage them to open their mouths and let him fill it with his presence. Beautiful Jesus, it's time to fly. It's time to soar. It's time to hear the lion roar again. Come on. Pray over your friend like you want them to pray over you. Declare a thing over your friend like you'd want them to declare over you. Release an impartation. Release the anointing. Holy Spirit, will you come? Will you come in your power? Whom can I send? Who? Whom can I send? It's time to fly. Come on, drink deep. Be greedy, be greedy, be greedy, be greedy. Drink him in. We need you, Jesus. We need you, Jesus. We need you, Jesus. Whoo. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come. You
You know, your impartation may just be what your neighbor needs this afternoon. They may not have had a hug. They may not have been told they're loved yet today. So use this opportunity to love the hell out of them this afternoon and to love heaven in. Spread the love of heaven because he's worthy. Ooh. Ah, beautiful King, holy King. Ooh, Jesus. Ah. Never get bored of having another drink of him. Never get bored. Oh, ooh. So just let him come. Ooh.
Some of you are praying for each other. Please stop that. You're supposed to be changing the person's
life. Come on, impartation.
You're supposed to be imparting. You're supposed to be ransacking. You're supposed to be ambushing. No one in the room should be praying denominational quiet prayers right now. You're changing the life of the person next to you. You are definitely not praying right now. Release the kingdom.
Bless
release the
fly.
River.
Bless them to fly. Bless them to fly. Bless them to fly. Come on. Shikaramanayane.
Never the same again. Never the same again.
Worthy God. Ooh, come on. Would you thicken your presence, Holy Spirit?
Just let him come. Let it come through the hands of the person next to you.
Fly.
Release the kingdom. Release the kingdom.
It's time to soar. It's time to hear like a roar. Come on.
Let the wind of his breath
flow.
It's not striving, flying.
You can fly.
And I believe I can fly.
And I prophesy this is a new season. This is a new day. This is a new season. This is a new day. Come on, it's time to
fly.
Holy Spirit, will you come? Keep coming, Holy Spirit. Undo us in your love today, God. It's time to fly. It's time to soar. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Come on a little bit higher.
Thank you, Jesus.
New atmospheres. New atmospheres.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
Some of you are waiting for something to happen, not realizing that everything is happening. You just need to say yes.
Say
Thank you, Jesus. Wow. Why don't you speak over your friend for those of you that aren't out of it right now. Just declare, I bless you with the yes of heaven this afternoon. Come on, I bless you to yield. I bless you to say yes. You know, when scripture says, whom can I send? It's a question. In Isaiah 6, who can I send for us? Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, whom can I send? So he's looking for your yes. It's a question. It's a question of where's your yes? Are you willing? Are you willing to yield? Are you willing to lay it down? Are you willing to say yes? Are you willing to worship? Are you willing to abandon yourself? It's all about the yes. The yes. Whom can I send? Ooh. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you. It's true. And a reminder to each of you, the word impossible does not exist in heaven. The word impossible, I just felt an intersecting thought. Some of you think you're facing impossible mountains. Well, I've got news for you. He's the great I am, not the great I was. He's the one who was and is to come, but he's greater than any mountain. So for anyone in this room tonight who thinks you face an impossible mountain, you just look at that mountain and you say, you shift because you're in my daddy's way. You're in my way. And if you're in my way, oh, you bow down to the name of Jesus. The word impossible does not exist in heaven's dictionary. And I bless you with a realization once again that he's big. He's God. He's able. Oh. Death, where is your sting? Thank you, Jesus. Oh. I just felt, just stretch out your hands to the worship guys tonight, this afternoon. You know, what worship stands for in this place is something beautiful, and you guys prophesy at the same time as leading us into the heavenly places. And I want to bless the anointing of worship on Catch the Fire World, but there's particularly being on this house that is flowing out of this house. And we bless you for new levels. We bless you to take this world by force. And I just felt influence. Doors are going to open. You're going to be asked to teach and to minister and raise up young ones in the values that you've been learning. And I bless you guys in this house. Ben and Jonathan and Alice and all of you amazing ones. Lead the charge. Hope. Continue to prophesy through song. Continue to bring heaven down through song. Hope. Continue to raise our faith through song. Impartation through song. And we honor the anointing on you all. And we thank you for being outrageously awesome in this place. Someone say amen. Someone say amen like you mean amen. Come on. Woo. He's so good. Wow. Oh my goodness.
Amen.
Amen. You can do whatever you want right now. Within reason. I feel a little bit hot up here. It's kind of toasty. Woo. Does anyone else feel a bit toasty? Just me. Anyone else feel like they're really hot or his Holy Spirit is so good? My word. Wowzers. Ah. So, so good.
Amen.
Amen.
What I love about Catch the Fire conferences is that you don't have to teach people how to receive. I love the fact that Chloe said, it's time to spread your wings, and about 95% of the room went,
ooh, ha.
Like, we go to a lot of churches doing values of Catch the Fire into other denominations. It's what one of the jobs that Chloe and I have. And, you know, when we go to churches that don't really understand us, We say things like, we have to teach them that when, you know, when it's time to spread your wings, you can actually spread your wings.
Come on.
But I just had a word that there was some people in the room that when you've been taught to spread your wings, you've thought you have to flap really hard.
You don't.
And I felt God saying that it's time to realize that most sensible birds don't flap a lot. They find the thermal.
Whoosh.
And they rise on the thermals.
Come on.
And so when it's time to spread your wings, doesn't mean it's time to get to work. It means it's actually time to relax.
Come on.
When your wings are by your side, you can't find thermals. But when your wings are out, you get to catch the updraft of the Holy Spirit. And so why don't you just shut your eyes and just receive that? Yeah, why don't you put your hands, arms out, put your wings out. And just, why don't you just repent to the Father for all the times when you've thought you've had to flap really hard.
Yeah.
All the times when you did all the work and not realized that he's got thermals of the Holy Spirit all around you.
Come on.
And your job is just to be vulnerable and submissive to the updrafts of what God is already doing in your worlds.
Why don't you choose to say, I choose to say, whoosh with you, Holy Spirit. Whoosh, up, up, up and away. Whoosh. It's like a beautiful whoosh. Up you go. Up you go. And Father, we prophesy in this place that this is the start of an incredible season of higher heights. It's like higher heights, higher levels, like the precision of the eagle eye perspective. They can see from higher heights. And I really felt that there was going to be an intense season of seeing in so much more detail than we've ever seen or sensed before. So anyone want to receive that right now, just say yes to him. You know, we need it for our churches, for our families, healing the sick, raising the dead, when to say yes, when to say no. We need the precision of the heights and the eagle eye perspective. Ooh, I say yes. Come on. Amazing. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Wow.
Okay, we've got some resources we'd like to identify and place before you. There's this couple called Marcel and Ruth Preston.
Woohoo!
Who were leading worship this afternoon. How many people were blessed by their worship this afternoon?
Come on.
You know, someone came up to me in church a few years ago now and said, I didn't really like the worship. I didn't get anything from it. I said, oh, that's okay. It wasn't for you. But what a bonus when we receive from the worship, even though God is the one who receives the worship. And this house has, I don't know, just amazing, amazing. And Ruth and Marcel have got two albums that I've got in my hand. There's a Soaking and the Unfailing Love album. They are amazing. As a couple, they are amazing. They're not just great at what they do. They are amazing as a couple. And what I love is when gifted, anointed people also have awesome character. And that couple are a real deal. So please buy everything you can. Well, I heard a rumor that they were going to start sacking Tammy if you didn't buy things. And so
he's
I'm joking.
Joking.
Sacking. Oh, what's sacking?
Don't
yeah, that's
know.
Fine.
Don't
I was
know.
Joking anyway.
There's a flash sale in the bookstore.
Yeah.
Woo! Today and tomorrow, there's 15% off all giftware. So go to the back, have a look around. There's some incredibly beautiful things. I mean, Kate's already kind of grabbed this. There's some beautiful things for the walls and gifts to give away. So go today and tomorrow. There's 15% off all giftware. We've also got Bill Johnson's new book, I think, in French, is stocked today in the back in the gift shop. So go grab that if you know anyone who speaks French or you speak French yourself. And we also have the incredible Steve Long's books. Woo! Someone say woo! Steve Long's The Faith Zone is out, and I'm really excited about this book. You know, Steve simplifies so much that we've all complicated.
Yeah.
You know, and the kingdom of God is not complicated. It's not complicated. And Steve's way of writing is just exceptional. So grab this book. It is off the charts. We've read it already, and there's a bit of my testimony, I think, in it. And I'm really excited to see this get out there. We're going to be taking a bunch to Kenya. It's amazing. So again, that's in the bookshop at the back. And there was one more thing, I think.
Two other books as well, On the Run, which is a study into what happened with David in the Bible. And there's great leadership messages in this book. Who's a leader in the room? See, I believe we all are.
Come on.
Anyone who has influence over anyone else is a leader in my book. And so this book will give you great skills and lessons from the life of David. And my healing belongs to me. I absolutely love bringing Steve and Sandra to church in London for one reason, well, for many reasons, but for one reason more than any other is that I know when we go for a curry afterwards, Steve is going to stretch my faith. Because every single time, before we've even ordered, Steve is healing someone in the room. It's amazing. It's how you get free curry. But my healing belongs to me is a lesson in healing the sick. And someone in London was asking me about Steve, and they didn't know our movement, and they hadn't heard of Steve. And I said, if you bring Steve to your church, he will simplify healing the sick. And not only that, he will demonstrate healing the sick in a way that you don't see many other people do. And it's incredible. And so that is a great resource. My healing belongs to me.